Star City, Indiana. It's a fitting name for the unlikely home to some of the state's most famous residents. Each year, hundreds trek from around the country to see them. No, not them. Them. That's right. The 140 cows that reside at this fourth generation dairy farm.
I've always enjoyed the farming. I remember we had a tour of some children from Marshall and Fulton County, and they were here, and I said, when I was a child, I used to play in the yard down there in my sand pile with tractors and trucks, and the only thing that's changed is the size of my toys. I just use bigger toys now to do the same thing I've always wanted to do, and that was farm.
For Sam, dairy farming is in his blood. His grandfather started the farm in 1919, and in 1956, his father built their first milking parlor. But when Sam took over, his focus wasn't on where the cows were milked, but how the cows were milked.
There was an article in a farm magazine about robots being put in use over in Europe. And my wife, Pam, said that I made a comment that, boy, someday I'd like to own some of those. The three times a day milking was the major thing back then. If you milk a cow three times a day over twice a day, you'll increase your milk production by 10 to 14% with no other forces being implemented. But the labor is a real issue with that. With robots, they do it 24 hours a day and it eliminates the labor problem. I don't know why, it just made so much sense to me. I call ourselves cowologists. It's about what the cow is thinking and wanting. I know that seems silly, but it really what the cow wants to do. It's totally up to her.
Robotic milkers became available in the Netherlands in 1992, but it took another 8 years for them to be introduced in the US. When the Jones installed their robots in 2003, they were one of only 10 robotic dairies in the nation.
They actually interviewed us before they said we could buy the robots to make sure we were robot material. We would understand and be able to learn all of this. And after they did that quick interview and came and visited our facility and spoke with us, they said, well, yeah, you will work well. They basically said, we're going to train the cows first and then we'll teach you. And so the cows learned how to do the robot thing and we kind of stepped back and watched and helped in the process. And it did take some cows a little longer than others and some took off and learned it first time through. And it's still that way. Even we have a new mama that just calves and we're bringing her up for the very first time and introducing her to the robot. It takes a little while. It's just their personality.
And just like a personal signature, each cow provides unique milk characteristics that the robot can record and track.
The cow steps onto the robot and it's ID'd. And each cow has a electronic ID tag that's also the activity tag. So if she's ID'd and it says she needs to be milked, the robot arm will proceed to stimulate and clean her teats each quarter. And the robot tracks color of milk. It does a conductivity test on the milk. If milk is abnormal due to being in heat or the cow is sick or along those lines, the robot gets a reading and alerts us to check this cow for what might be wrong with her. It lets us treat our cows before the infection really gets a hold of the cow, so it takes less antibiotics. It just gives you a wealth of information to make the animal more healthy and hopefully help other farmers too.
Each year, the Jones provide hundreds of tours, not just to local school children, but also to fellow dairy farmers, hoping to raise awareness about the benefits, especially for small farms, where the introduction of robots can dramatically improve lifestyle, increasing family time without decreasing livelihood.
My dad used to be really happy if we would ship 1 million pounds a year. This year, we're on a goal to almost ship 3 million pounds of milk on pretty much the same amount of land for the dairy. The stress on the animal is so much less. There's no waiting, uncomfortable, can't sleep, can't lay down. Robots are always open.
The happy mood of the herd caused an unexpected change. No moo in the herd.
We don't hear a lot of mooing on our farm. It was hard to get used to because the cows mooed a lot when we milked the other way, wanting to be fed, wanting maybe to lay down, and we had them in the holding area. And we didn't really realize that until we got the robots and we heard no mooing one day, and we actually called a professor at Purdue and asked, you know, our cows don't moo anymore. And he said, well, they don't want for anything. They really do like the laid-back approach of letting them pick and choose when they want to eat, letting them choose when they want to lie down. If they want to stand out in the cow lot in the rain, they can. If they want to stand out in the sunshine, they do. I've seen cows licking icicles off the barn. They're almost like kids. That's the part I enjoy the most about the cows, is actually seeing their unique personality. I've always had a connection with animals. I really have a degree in radiology, but I quit the day before we got married to become a dairy farmer, and that was 37 years ago, and I wouldn't change that for anything.